Okay, this one we're calling the Hitch Your Giddyup. Okay, so in this particular case, if you think about the old West days, you're picking, you're hopping on a horse, so you have your legs straddling. In this, what we're doing is we're hitching up at the apex of your hips, where your legs join, and you're working to do the lift. Now, at this point, we're looking at controlling one leg. So when I'm coming in through here like this, I go like that and I do the lift. It doesn't require you to get so low on the person to disrupt their base or to control them. So when I'm coming in here, it's not one that you go down low. You are hitching up their giddy up. So my leg comes in through here to control my lift. My hips are in, so this doesn't work if your hips are back. You'll are away from the person, because then you'll start injuring your back on the lift. So every time that you're in here, if you're scooping low, get your hips up fast. And so now you're in this position to manipulate a person to wherever you want them to go. And this is where, if you're passing under, we start this lift. You'll see that I have control of that leg every time, and that's what makes that work. You can get this from the outside as well. I'm passing through here, however I happen to get. It might be through a whizzer, it might be through a lot of different things, where I just pass the arm and I scoop. Now, I keep my head pressure in tight, because I want to offset their head. I want to offset their base a little bit. Not just laterally, but also in the Z-plane backwards. So as I'm doing that, I release here, and we'll do the pickup right at that point. And from there, it's a matter of fly them over your shoulder. It's a matter of slamming them into something else. It's a matter of just picking up and dropping. You'll be working with a lot of pressure where you can bump out the other leg right here. It's really a sweet position. You can hook this leg at that point with your hand, pull down, and I'm being nice at this point, but you would grab up high and you would scoop like that as they drop down. It's a hard hit for them to land, so they have to know how to break fall during training. Here's a little thing for those people who are there. I'll just choke you, dude, punch you. If I'm in here like this, we're assuming this is a fight, so I've already struck headbutt, that sort of thing, on my way in. And if I go here like this, and I do a suplex, bam, it's not hard for me to drop this person hard on their head and shoulder. And I don't even have to lift high. I just have to pull up, and I just have to move my base under and slam back. And it's not a hard movement. Once I get that here, I don't have to do a high lift. I just do that leg, bam, just like that. And I turn over. So they have the thought of the hit. So again, we're struggling, we're coming in. Bam, that's a headbutt. Pitch, wham, and they're down. So in that short time, and I'm going slow right now for safety, but if I were to speed that up, that person doesn't have time to wrap your head. That person doesn't have time to hit you in the face. If they do wrap your head, that gives me more leverage to plow their upper body into the ground where I want them, because then I use my head direction to control where that I want that upper body to land. And I will land on them as I rotate over. So people who have that mentality of, I'll just punch you and I'll just do that. Yeah, if I'm going slow as molasses, you know, if I'm really taking my time at it, anybody can do anything. But this is done on a fast entry in and slam. I mean, it's over. I mean, inside of a second, 1 second that can occur. So 2 seconds if the person's really struggling. But that's it.